Hello children, in our today's session, we will cover the topic gap filling, editing or omission, sentence reordering. But before starting, let us just discuss about our learning objective so that we would know that what we are going to learn after the completion of this topic. So, you will have learned how to choose appropriate words to fill in the blanks, have learned how to fill in appropriate words that have been omitted in the passage, have learned how to rearrange words into meaningful sentences. Children, this topic is mainly based on our basic grammar knowledge and it is a scoring part. So you must count upon scoring, earning these marks, doing it all correctly. So first of all, let us take a simple example. We are taking one simple paragraph. Yes, have a look. Anjali is studying dash simple machines in her class. Simple machines are tools we use to dash work easier. Anjali's homework is to look around her house and find dash example of each simple machine. So, after just reading this, what comes to us that this is about Anjali who is studying about simple machines and she is searching for some example. Fine. So, here what is the speciality of this paragraph that each line, first line is always connected to the second one. So, sometimes what happens when we read the first sentence and we are not getting the answer. After that, if we read the second one, we might get our answer correctly. So let us try. Anjali is studying dash simple machines. Anjali is studying her simple machines. About simple machines. Yes, I think this is the right answer. She is studying about simple machines in her class. Simple machines are tools we use to what we used to do to make our work easier. So I think make would be the right answer here. Then Anjali's homework, she got some homework also, is to look around her house and find out for one example. For one example, it is an example of each simple machine. After that, at first she dashed a hard time finding even one simple machine. It seems that earlier, initially, means it is not in present, so she had a hard time finding even one simple machine. Then Anjali, it could be realized or remembered, anything, both are correct. Then Anjali remembered that the things we use every day may not look like a machine, but they still made work easier. So this is our first paragraph that we have solved. Let us just cross check our answers. Yes, Anjali is studying about simple machines in her class and our tools we use to make work easier than look around her house and find an example of each simple machine. Correct. At first she had a hard time. Right answer. Then Anjali remember that the things we use every day may not look like a machine, but they still made work easier. So after looking at these words, which are in red color, about, make, and, had, remember, may, what we can observe that these words are from our basic grammar topics. Prepositions we have articles, we have modals, we have tenses, our verb forms. So let us just quickly brush up our understanding of the basic grammar topics and then we'll try to solve our exercise. The topics we will cover: prepositions, tenses, verb forms, articles and modals. Let us start with preposition. A preposition is a word used to link nouns, pronouns, phrases to other words within a sentence. They act to connect the people, objects, time, and location of a sentence. Prepositions are usually short words and they are normally placed directly in front of the noun. And this is a list. We all know about prepositions: above, across, before, behind, on, in, beside, between, within, upon, with. So this is about preposition. Next is our, yes, the basic thing, our tenses. Fine, we all know about present tense, past, future, and their forms also: simple form, progressive form, perfect form, perfect progressive forms. And these are the rules which we have to follow. Fine, and this is a list of our verb forms that we have to use on basis of our tenses, whether it is present, past, or past participle. We have to just check that thing. See, except, accepted, accepted, leave, left, left. So we have to just check that first, what kind of tense we are having, and accordingly we use verb form. Ask, asked, asked, write, wrote. Next is about our articles, a and the. We all know about this. So let us just see where to use a, where to use an, and the. The we use for specific object. A and an are used for objects that are not specific. Fine. So let us just have an example. A man is a social animal. The man who is in black coat. So this is the difference here. Now let us just check where to use a and where to use an. We use a for word before words beginning with a consonant sound, and an for words used before words that begin with a vowel sound. Next is our modal. These are the auxiliary verbs like can, will, should, shall, must, might, and should. Modal verbs, they are used for what? They are just expressing. They are just used to for expressions, for possibility, for ability, for permission, for obligation, for ability of a person. So this is about our basic grammar topic. It is always advisable to look at the option when you get any kind of question and try to fit in all the given options. Whatever options we get, we should try to fit in all the given options. Sometimes what happens, children, we may get the option which looks similar. What helps us there? Our knowledge of basic grammar topics. So let us start with gap filling. This is the format of the question. The question with what kind of question we will get in our question paper. Read this carefully. Fill in the following blanks, choosing the most appropriate option from the ones given below. Most appropriate option means we may have two or three options. Those may look similar, but we have to choose the most appropriate here. Let us start. An inadequate public transport system has dash to an increase dash the number of vehicles. Fine, here also first line is connected to the next one and so on. Let us read it again. An inadequate public adequate public transport system has, what would come? Leads, led, let's, been leading. So as per my knowledge, led would come here to an increase in the, see, automatically this in comes here to an increase in the number of vehicles. We just try to, before trying to fit that into the fill up, we should read the sentence, and sometimes things come as to automatically. Let us check, do we have this option? Yes, in is there. To an increase in the number of vehicles on the road, again same thing happened. It comes to us automatically. Bad roads and hawkers on roads and footpaths have added. When we have this addition to the, so let us try this, have added, yes, to the traffic woes of commuters. Traffic problems need to, when we have any deadline, what is the thing? It need to be done. So let us try that here also. Traffic problem need to be solved because valuable time and energy is lost in traffic jam. Now let us cross check our answers with our answer scheme. So our first answer is let, second is in, fine, third one is on, fourth to, fifth is be solved. So let's find out how much we score, children. 5 out of 5. Good going. With this, it is a good going. So with this, let us come to editing or omission, our next part. Sometime what happened when we have sentences, it looks the there is no error in that. It is okay. But when we just read that carefully, we can observe few words are missing. So in this kind of question, where one word has been omitted in each line, what we have to do? We have to find the missing word. And this is the best way to solve this question. Just make this table in your answer sheets. And in this missing word, you have to write the missing word here. And here the word that is before the missing word and the word that is after the missing word. Let us just have a look. First example is done for you. When Sania landed her hometown. Fine. Where she landed? In. Landed in her. This is the example. And we have to follow this. Just to solve our question. When Sania landed in her hometown, her face was radiant joy. Her face was radiant with, her face was radiant with joy. The warm welcome. Who received the warm welcome? Sania. So here we are using pronoun. The warm welcome. Who received? Instead of repeating the name, we can use the warm welcome she received made her emotional. She hadn't expected. Again, she hadn't expected. See, something is missing. I think two would come here. She hadn't expected to see so many people had. So many people had traveled from. So many people who had traveled from all over to meet and greet. To meet and greet whom? Her. To meet and greet her on her feet. Fine. So let us just check our answer scheme. Yes, it's here. Radiant with joy, right? Welcome she received. Expected to see people who had greet her on. Fine. Next is, this is your assignment for omission, for missing words. You have to do it yourself. Now let us come to our third part. That is sentence reordering. It is very interesting if you try to just find out what they mean. It is kind of jumbled words. They are just misplaced and you have to arrange those to make a complete sentence. So what rule we are following here? Subject, that we all know, then helping verb, our main verb and object. Let's try with the example. So the question is, rearrange the following words and phrases to form meaningful sentences. The first one is, of mankind, the habit reading is one of resources of the greatest. So with these words, what comes to us that it is about reading habit of people. Let us try to solve this. So it's about habit. Let's start with this. The habit of reading of mankind. Okay, the habit of reading is one of the greatest resources of mankind. I think this is the right sentence here. I'm repeating. The habit of reading is one of the greatest resources of mankind. As we discussed, first sentence is linked to the second one. It is connected. So let us see. Are we enjoy that belong to us than if much more borrowed reading books. It is about some how do we enjoy and borrowed books. It is also about books. So let us try to make it a proper sentence. We enjoy reading books that belong to us much more than if they are borrowed. Yes, this is the right sentence. We enjoy reading books that belong to us much more than if they are borrowed. Come to the second last. This is book formality. A certain considerate must be treated with a borrowed. I think it is something like what we should do with borrowed books. So again, let us try. A borrowed book must be treated with a certain formality. Yes, a borrowed book must be treated with a certain considerate formality. These are the guidelines. Fine. And the last one now. Them borrowing books, never the giving worse habit and back is. Fine. Let us try to frame this one also. It is about the habits. Worst habit, fine. The worst habit is borrowing books and never them back. And never giving them back. We shouldn't do that. So the worst habit, this is the fourth one. The worst habit is borrowing books and never giving them back. Let us check. Yes, I'm reading for you. The habit of reading is one of the greatest resources of mankind. We enjoy reading books that belong to us much more than if they are borrowed. A borrowed book must be treated with a certain considerate formality. The worst habit is borrowing books and never giving them back. So just what you need to do, just try to frame the whole sentence with your own knowledge. Means whatever appears right, whatever appears correct to your mind. And that comes with practice. As we all know, practice makes a man perfect. So with practice, you will be able to crack these type of questions without any error. And you can score good marks. So this is your assignment for rearranging sentences. First one I am reading for you. Greatest mysteries, bird life, migration, one of the, of is. So from these jumbled words even, the idea is clear that it is about bird life, what is the greatest mystery there, and it is about the migration. Please try to solve this, children. I hope with this much discussion, the idea is clear to you all. So you all can just score good in this kind of question. Thank you so much.